welcome to Art of Ajin, the show that gonna provide you all kind of interesting arts, including music, movie, theater, and paintings. And today we are still talking about the Art on Farm project, which held at the Jim Thompson Farm. Last week we have been talking with three artists, and we have two more to talk with today. Who are they? Let's see. Rajapan was born in Bangkok. She has accomplished doctoral degree in architecture from the University of Tokyo. She works in both research and design, focused on contemporary vernacular architecture in Asia. Currently based in Bangkok, she is teaching at the Faculty of Architecture, Chulalongkorn University, and is working as an architect with Allzone Company, where she is a co-founder.
We are not artists, we are architects and designers. Our main job is usually to design physical environment and space. When we were invited to work on this farm project, we were interested in creating a space where people could dine together, is a dining space for people, as kind of picnic space under the trees. The environment is little wood, and our idea is to improve this space that actually is already very nice, it's nature, but to make it a little bit more familiar and to invite people to enjoy the space better. We would like to make something that still retain the dominance of the nature, but to insert a very light element to actually blend with the nature, but at the same time it's not nature. So it is a kind of something in between that it actually could be transformed by nature, meaning that the structure is very light and it's blowing all the time by the winds, and is so transparent enough that you could see the lights get through. And actually, when you look at them, you still see the wood, but you see all this structure, this light structure, as a kind of an insert environment rather than an object. The meaning, actually, of this installation, we just would like to show something that is very local, very, very traditional, but we just twist it into a more contemporary use. And we would like to show that, actually, there's a lot of interesting aspect of local cultures that probably we haven't understood them very well yet. But if we try to look at this culture more closely, we would see that we could use them in several ways and could develop into something that we could use in our contemporary life. The material is actually a very light fabric that in Thailand, usually this fabric is used for to signify a sacred space. For example, when people believe that this tree is very sacred, probably there's some spirits residing in the trees, people would actually wrap the trees with very colorful fabrics, and this is the kai. Very cheap, very light, very local. at the beginning, we were interested in something very traditional or local, and we found these paper cut elements that actually widely used in Thailand, in the north, in the northeast, or in the central Thailand, that people would use a rectangular paper, very light, and fold it and cut it into a shape that in the north, they call it tung. It's tung sai mu. And in the central Thailand, it's called puong mahot. While in the northeast, they call it the puong malai. And this kind of paper cut is used at a temple festival. It's a kind of decorative element. But usually they make it very small, like this size, and with a very light paper. But then we took the typology of that paper cut, and we studied several geometries. And finally, after studying for some time, we found that this geometry is probably very similar to the natural form, because the growth of the cut is in the geometry is very close to the golden proportion, so it looks very natural. And so we decided to use this geometry as the main pattern for the cutting. But usually the paper cut, traditionally they use it upside down, but we flip it like this. So it becomes like a triangle. It's like a cone shape. In the design and art field in Thailand, there are a lot of young, interesting people and who are trying to create something that come out from our local context. And lately, I personally started to see that there are a lot of interesting people trying to shape this kind of trying to use the local context in a very interesting way, and actually we are trying to be one of them too. And I think in the art or in the contemporary art already, Thailand is very strong, probably the size slightly behind. But then I hope that in the very near future, in the design field, people would actually utilize the local materials or wisdom that we already have to use into the contemporary context better.
Artist for Art on Farm project is Songwit Pimpakhan. He was born in 1970 in Ubon Ratchathani and received MFA from Silapakorn University, Bangkok. Currently, he lives and works at the Faculty of Fine Art Applied Arts, University of Khon Kaen.
You're tuned to the station that plays the best music in town.
This theater play called Open the Curtains, the local ritually work Sang Sin Chai or Sin Chai in a traditional Isan story that is presented through writing, folk music,
no.
Shadow plays and mural print.
No, just leave it like it is.
All right, fine.
And that was just the first art of today. We have got a lot more in the upcoming breaks. Stay tuned.